Meanwhile, funeral homes across South Africa have called off work for about 3 days as a mark of protest. They have vowed not to collect corpses after the government has failed to respond to their demands. Now, nearly about 3,000 funeral industry employees came out onto the streets and protested and said that they want change. The workers are demanding for a change to a host of different procedures and regulations, including some introduced in the wake of the coronavirus pandemic. They say that these changes actually make it hard for small black-owned parlors to operate and give big players an advantage. They're also demanding a COVID-19 relief fund to help the industry cope with the pandemic.
I'm a relief fund as long as we're told as I'm an undertaker. So Nati, we are frontline workers. We are putting our lives at risk each and every day because we are dealing with Abashuruni.
We've been paying premiums. We've had to actually let them know that, you know what, we are unable to come into house pickups. Please call the SAPS or the forensics team to actually come and do the house pickups for you. A lot of people could not understand as to why we could not do that.
Meanwhile, several South African families are left searching for someone to collect the bodies of their deceased relatives. In a country with one of the world's highest coronavirus mortality rates, the Department of Health has warned that the strike that's been put forth by the people in the funeral industry actually poses a public health risk. Now, there are nearly about 650,000 confirmed cases of coronavirus infections and about 15,500 deaths that have been reported linked to COVID-19.